y'all. It's Io here from Noodle Nook, and I just wanted to come to you real quick with a talk about teacher burnout. Is this you this time of year? Just overwhelmed, frustrated, a teacher on the edge. It's about this time of year that starts to happen, right? You're sitting back in your classroom, you just had a day, yesterday was a day, the day before that was a day. It's been a long string of days. And you're starting to ask yourself, in the quietness of a room with no students, is this the right job for you? How much longer can you do this? And the truth is, a lot of teachers leave the classroom every year because when they ask themselves that question, the answer is, I could be somewhere else. I could do something different. Maybe this isn't the job for me. Now, you know as well as I do that you got into this because you love the kids and you really love education. There is something inside of you that makes you want to be a teacher. So what are some things that you can do to maybe squelch that overwhelming feeling and make it so that it doesn't feel like a losing battle every day you come to school? So I've got three tips real quick that I would love for you to reflect on right now, this time of year, just about how things are going in your classroom and what you can do to maybe make a little change that makes a big, profound difference. So the first thing I want you to do is tighten up your routine and procedures. We start off in the beginning of the school year and we always have all of these great ideas of the things that we're going to do. And then we try some things, we try some other things, we do this, we do that. All of a sudden we're trying to balance and juggle lots of balls in the air. And this time of year, I just want you to stop for a moment, just stop and pause and ask yourself what's really working and what's really not, so that you can discard the things that are not effective. The other part of that is, have you introduced the things that you really need as part of your routine and procedures? Are you using a visual schedule? Are you using a token board or reward system or reward chart? Are there effective visuals in your classroom? Do you have those three things if you're going to be teaching in an autism unit or a classroom with students with significant disabilities? Have you incorporated that? So you really have to tighten things up, get that routine and procedure rock solid, and then let go of the stuff that's not working for you. So that's the first tip I have for you, is to just tighten everything up, right? Get everything in shape. The next thing is to declutter. To declutter not only your physical environment, but also a little bit of the mental decluttering too. So to take a moment and just really look around your room and see, what are you using? What are you not using? The things that you are not using, pack up and move out of the way. Sometimes just part of getting your routine and procedure down is trying to find the materials that you need or dig out the stuff that you know you have, but you don't know exactly where it is. And that slows you down and makes you clunky. So just to declutter, just have out what you need and put everything away. And also a little bit of mentally decluttering. You've got a lot of things that you started and maybe didn't follow through of all the way, or things that you've been meaning to address that you didn't get to yet. Take care of those things so that you can mentally let them go. Take care of those things, or if you're not going to be able to effectively take care of them, discard them now so you can focus on the things that are in front of you. It's about making sure that the things on your plate are manageable, that you're not overwhelmed with all the stuff that you piled on top. So take a minute, declutter. All right, the third thing is to remember, you can only control what's inside of your four walls. There's a ton of other stuff that comes with being a SPED teacher. You're case managing, you're dealing with partner teachers, different classrooms, routine and procedures, behavior plan implementation from people from the bus driver to the cafeteria workers to home health care providers, parents. There's a lot going on. And it can start to feel like you're taking on everybody's problems, everybody's issues, everybody's concerns. Now, I'm not saying turn everybody off altogether, but we do have to take ownership of what's happening inside of our classroom, inside of our four walls, and let everybody else do their job. Everybody else has got a job in this, and it's time for everybody else to step up so you don't feel like it all falls on you. Those are the things that keep you up at night, right? You're lying in bed, you can't fall asleep, you're just running through all this stuff. We've got to let some of that go. I hate to sing a Frozen song, but it is playing in my head. We've got to let some of that go and just control what's inside of our four walls. And understand that we don't have to take the entirety of our classroom home at night. If you are staying till 6, 7, 8, 9 o'clock at night and still taking work home that you may or may not actually get to, it's time to really think, can that stay inside of the four walls? It will be there for me the next day. I will take care of it later. It can't be all of you all the time on overdrive and trying to control everybody around you. You can only focus on the things inside of your four walls. So I want you to take a moment to just focus on that. So those are the three things, right? This time of year, it's time to do a little review about feeling overwhelmed and a little bit frustrated, because we want to keep great teachers in the classroom. We need you. We need you. So can you tighten up your routine and procedures? Can you declutter a little bit, mentally and physically? And then can you just focus on what's going on inside of your four walls and not everything that's going on everywhere? If you can do those three things, I guarantee you will love your job more when you wake up in the morning. You will feel more successful at the end of the day. And you'll want to stay with us in the classroom, working with students who desperately need you. So it was Io here from Noodle Nook. I just wanted to bring you that today, a little reflection, and I hope that you do take those three things to heart and start doing them today. All right, y'all, stay strong and teach on.